Hi, in this video, we'll be discussing about the init containers. So init containers are just like regular containers, but they run to completion and they run before the main container starts. So in init containers, there can be various use cases for init containers. Like init containers can contain certain utilities or custom code for the setup that is not present for the app container, and it can also change the file system before even starting the app container based on certain logic. It can also be used to limit the attack surface by keeping certain tools as part of init containers. And init containers can also delay the start of the main containers by having some precondition check, and unless they are met, it will still keep on trying the init containers. So just to write the init containers, we have to specify that in the spec section. So in the spec section of the pod, we have to define the init containers. There can be one or more init containers. It will be running sequentially. So the first init container runs and then it completes, then the second one runs, it completes, and then the containers will start. So none of the lifecycle or the probes of the pod can be used for init containers. And that's pretty much it about the init containers. Let's see this YAML file. So we have containers. The main container is Nginx, and it has a volume mount, shared volume mount. And for the init container, what it's trying to do is it's trying to just get the HTML from civo.com and put that as an index.html file. So basically, init container will do a wget on civo.com, get the HTML file, and then the Nginx container will use that HTML file and will be serving that. So let's see that in action. Kubectl apply -f init one. Kubectl get pods. You can see the pod is initializing and it's running. So let's exec into the pod, kubectl exec -it init container, and do a curl localhost. So we can see the HTML file has been changed. So now what we do is we'll exit, and we'll also do a kubectl get pods and describe the pod. So kubectl describe pod init demo, and we can see the busy box was pulled first, the init container was started, and then the Nginx container was started. So that's how it is there. And you can also see the init container over here and what command it started. Now there's another example that I have, which is multiple init containers. So let's quickly see that as well. So do a cat on init2.yaml. So this is a multi-container, multiple init container pod. So we have a main container, which is a busy box, and in the init containers, we are checking for two services, whether they exist or not. So unless and until the services will exist, so we can see that it will check for app service and it will check for DB service. So if they do not exist, then this particular pod will always remain pending. So first, let's see whether we have service, and let me show you the service as well. So we have init2svc. So these are the services that we will also create so that the pod comes into the running state. Let's make sure that it's not running at the moment. So we'll do a delete -f just to make sure. Yes, they were there. So we have deleted that. Now let's apply the pod YAML first. So kubectl apply -f init 2, it created the pod, kubectl get pods. So its status is init 0 out of 2. So not even one container has completed successfully. Not even one init container has completed successfully. We can also describe that. So kubectl describe pod. And we can see it has just started and it will keep on retrying unless and until the init container is completed. So it's waiting. Now what we'll do is, let's apply the services. Kubectl apply -f init to svc. As soon as we apply the services, the pod starts initializing and the pod starts running. So in this lecture, we have seen how init container works, how a single init container and multiple init container works. They both, in any scenario, the init container will work to completion and then only the main or the app container will start in the pod. That's it for this lecture. Thank you for watching.